The other day, I spoke with a woman who had just turned 90 years old. She said that she has seen so many presidents throughout her lifetime, and she has never seen the country this divided. Then she went on to blame Trump and his supporters for dividing us. My first thought was that if you were born in 1930, you were 25 when Rosa Parks refused to get out of her seat. You were 33 when Democratic Governor George Wallace said, "I say segregation now, segregation tomorrow, segregation forever." And you were almost my age when MLK was assassinated. But right now, we're more divided? Here's the thing. If it's the people who support Trump that are dividing America, the question is, why? Why would the people who support the President of the United States want the citizens of the United States so divided? Why would a president want to divide the country he's been elected to lead? That would be detrimental to him getting anything done. A president does not gain anything by dividing the people. He only gains something by bringing people together. Only the party out of power can gain from the people being divided. But it's much deeper than that. Dividing the people is a progressive strategy. It's why the left practices identity politics and intersectionality. It's why they always demonize their opposition. After the State of the Union address, CNN's Van Jones warned fellow Democrats that Trump's criminal justice reform policies and prioritization of funding for historical black colleges could win over black voters. Let that sink in for a second. He's worried that Trump has done too many things that black voters like. In what world is that a problem? I'll tell you, in a world where the people who want power over us don't care about what we want. On one hand, Democrats call Trump a racist. And on the other, they're worried that he'll get reelected because he's done too many things that could win over black voters. Instead of celebrating that President Trump has done good things for black people, Democrats call him a racist and try to scare you out of voting for him. Now, we are divided. There's no doubt about that. A liberal friend of mine said that we're just one goose step away from being Nazi Germany. Of course, he had no basis for the comment when I pushed back. They always say that if you don't know your history, you're doomed to repeat it. But it's also true that if you don't know your history, you could be convinced that we are repeating it when we're not. My friend is sure that Trump is some kind of an authoritarian dictator, but he can't give me one example that makes him believe that. With the announcement that Rush Limbaugh has lung cancer, you can see who the people are that want us divided. All these out-of-context quotes are resurfacing to paint him as a racist. I saw one quote from Rush they're using, and it was this, quote, "We need segregated buses," unquote. No context is given about the statement, just that quote, and we're all supposed to believe that Rush Limbaugh is a segregationist. And why would Trump give the Medal of Freedom to a segregationist unless he himself is a racist? And these ignorant people really believe this nonsense. They've never once listened to a segment of the Rush Limbaugh show, but they're uber confident that they understand everything about him. The truth is, they're just so intellectually lazy, it's sad. And that laziness gets taken advantage of and abused by the people who want to divide us. Dividing the American people is something you do if you want to change America. It's not something you do if you want to change Washington or drain the swamp. A sitting president doesn't get more popular by dividing the people. Once you realize that and who a divided America benefits, you can see who's dividing us. And it's obviously not Donald Trump. A content population does not want to throw out the president. So Democrats have an incentive to divide us. I mean, the only way they'll mention that Trump has done good things for black people is when they're trying to figure out how to convince black people to not vote for him. Let me explain this in the simplest terms possible. If the majority of Americans came together behind Donald Trump, he would win the next election in a landslide, right? So then you tell me, why would he or his supporters try to divide the country? Think about it. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel, and if you want to become a supporting member of Blue Collar Logic, click on the link in the description and give what you can.